Assalamu alaikum, peace, greetings, hello. My name is Peyman Amiri. I have the honor and the pleasure of serving as chairman of the board at Islamic Cultural Center of Northern California. On behalf of the board members, staff, and the community members of Islamic Cultural Center of Northern California, I'd like to welcome you all to our house, to your house. It's a pleasure to see your kind faces. And we really enjoy when you come in and bring the positive energy. The mayor of Oakland had a program here several months ago. She had her State of City address. And I told her, during these concerts, the crowd that come here fill this place with positive energy and leave them behind. So nothing usually goes wrong during our programs because of all the positive energies that are deposited here. I also want to thank Zawaya, Aswad, and all the musicians who have worked so hard to put together a free concert for the community. I'll come back sometimes in probably an hour, 45 minutes, and we'll tell you what does it take to enjoy these free concerts. And then I'll ask you, if you're enjoying the music, then you need to think, how do we make this sustainable together? Thank you.
Long bathroom line. Good evening, everybody. Before we begin our program, we'd like to speak briefly about the circumstances that led us all here today. Given the constant updates of a lunatic's tweets and the media's focus on distracting nonsense, it's sometimes hard to form a clear picture of reality. A large part of our coming together tonight concerns who we are. We are all immigrants, excluding Native Americans and those forced to migrate as slaves, for who an entanglement of historical reasons have found ourselves in a perilous situation we have been challenged to influence. It's important to remember, however, the debt this country owes immigrants. Immigration has long been central to the growth and dynamism of the United States. Immigrants and refugees are entrepreneurs, job creators, taxpayers, and consumers. We add trillions of dollars to the U.S. gross domestic product, and our economic importance will only increase in the coming decades. In the Bay Area alone, growth based now on innovation in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, is represented 42% by immigrants. Nevertheless, despite the positive impacts of immigrants in the United States economy and society, a new racist collective threatens to move the country to a more restrictionist policy environment. Increased immigration enforcement, as well as potential restrictions on legal immigration and refugee resettlement, will impose fiscal costs on taxpayers, billions of dollars, and threaten immigrants, their families, and their local communities across the country. Stepping up deportations and detentions will not only cost taxpayers billions and will break families apart and place vulnerable individuals, such as survivors of domestic violence and sexual assault in the United States, as well as women and children fleeing violence in their homelands, in peril. Approximately 800 young undocumented immigrants have received work permits and protections from deportation through the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program, or DACA. The program's future, however, is uncertain after Trump's recent announcements of plans to phase it out. I myself am a DACA recipient. Thank you. I migrated to this country from Mexico in 1999, but since before my arrival, there have been a continuous movement to fix this country's immigration problem. In 2012, there was an attempt to amend these issues. Immigration youth. Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals gave temporary relief from deportation for 2 years to immigrants that came here before 2007, before the age of 15. But who fought for this? It was immigrant youth that occupied Obama's campaign offices. But oftentimes, people try to erase history where protests and direct actions created change and say it was done by presidents or people in positions of power. What we like to remind people is that we have the power. Right now, DACA has been taken. Right now, DACA has been taken away from us. Although they are currently accepting renewals, it is not a certainty that they won't take it away again. Which is why I urge folks tonight to continue fighting for a just world where borders are not stopping anyone from traveling or being with their families. We fight not only for immigrant youth, but those who fought before us, trying to give us a better life. For my parents, who have worked tirelessly without papers, because papers cannot legitimize our humanity. We fight with our actions. Right now in the Bay Area, there is a current threat of massive raids. And that is why I urge you folks at the end, please grab a flyer. It has a number of rapid response networks where you can call in case you hear of a raid happening in your county. It has all the Bay Area counties from Contra Costa all the way down to San Mateo and Monterey County. And also, if you want to volunteer and be one of the people that put themselves in front and as an ally, go check up and see if it's a real raid, because we don't want to create panic, we want to create power. We cannot isolate these challenges from the larger problem of racism, Islamophobia, and systemic inequalities. The influx of refugees is a direct consequence of war, and it's the American war machine that fuels these conflicts and is enthusiastically supported by an arms industry whose stocks on Wall Street depend on the constant devastation of people and places. Those places have names and include Yemen, Syria, Iraq, Libya, and Palestine. with its eternal capital, Jerusalem, all of whose people have suffered immensely from the persistence of America's military intervention and imperial domination in the global south. These conflicts are hardly limited to the Middle East and North Africa, but have also been imposed on Central and South America, who have seen corrupt dictatorships sponsored by US and its allies, the World Bank and the IMF have enforced crushing debts, privatizations, austerity measures, not to mention using diplomatic blackmail, covert espionage, and proxy death squads. There is at this moment a refugee crisis on our southern border, where women, some who are pregnant, unoccupied minor children, and families have the perilous journey seeking refuge from the violence that has overwhelmed their home countries. El Salvador, Mexico, Guatemala are currently among the top 10 deadliest countries in the world, alongside Syria and Iraq. When these refugees arrive at the border, they are detained in inhumane conditions, often in facilities run by private corporations profiting from this misery. Children are separated from their families. The so-called legal system at the border is designated to expedite the deportation of these women, men, and children as quickly as possible. Statistics show that without an attorney, and most will never have the benefit of having one, genuine refugees will lose their asylum case and be sent back to the dangerous situations they fled and quite possibly sent back to their deaths. Meanwhile, this administration has decided to end temporary protected status, designation for nearly 200,000 Salvadorians. But as we know, art can be a powerful vehicle for change. And so we come together as immigrants, refugees, some of the most vulnerable members of this society, to challenge these debilitating conditions and resist the forces of this society. To challenge that accept to silence us and banish us from influencing public policy. We stand to deliver a musical message to tell these forces that this treatment won't pass. There is no time to retreat to the shadows in fear. Every person who lives and works in this country deserves to have their basic rights respected. America is our home too, and we're not going anywhere. And for our first part of the program, we will be having songs in Arabic, Turkish, and Persian.
Thank you. No! Bilmiyorum ne halde. Gündüz gece, gündüz gece. Thank you.
And up next, we will be having San Jose Taiko. And I would like to welcome Franco Imperial, the artistic director.
Good evening. We are San Jose Taiko. My name is Franco Imperial. I'm artistic director for the company. And it is our honor and privilege to be sharing the stage with such amazing and compassionate artists tonight. Can we give them a round of applause, please? Our company was formed in 1973 to use the taiko as a way to explore and express the Asian soul of America. The work we are doing tonight with Aswat Ensembles, our new friends at Aswat Ensemble, celebrates and expands on that work. The first piece we'll be playing tonight is called Aswat Matsuri, written by our own San Jose Taiko's Jeff Noon, and features Loai Darbur from Aswat Ensemble. Matsuri means festival in Japanese, and Matsuri Taiko is a song that taiko groups all over the world play at Japanese festivals and other occasions. And the goal was to take the traditional patterns from the matsuri that we play, combine them with the traditional patterns that Loai will be playing of Arab percussion to create a festival of our own here to celebrate groups coming together, communities coming together. So we hope you enjoy Aswat Matsuri. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. The next piece we're going to perform is called Day of Remembrance, and it's named after an event that happens in San Jose, Japan town called Day of Remembrance, which its purpose is to commemorate and peacefully protest the Executive Order 9066, which in World War II unjustly incarcerated over 120,000 Japanese Americans. Now, this piece was inspired, I wrote this piece. I composed it, and thank you. They always remind me, you should say who wrote this. It was inspired in 2003 at a Day of Remembrance event in our Japantown, when a Muslim American woman speaking recognized it was the Japanese American community that was the first to come to the Muslim American community's aid in the events after 9/11. And that really spoke to me. Thank you. And so this piece isn't necessarily about protest as much as it is more about how communities come together to stand up. It's the reason we're all here tonight, yes. So, thank you. And the piece traces the journey of the Japanese American internment from fear and panic to the removal from folks' own homes, to be transported to camp, to the confusion of one's identity as an American, resolving with the communities that come together like they do today to support each other. I've got to give special thanks to George Corey for this wonderful arrangement. We've been working on it, and the first time he shared with me the orchestral portion of it, I was floored. It sounds like an entirely different song. The song was originally composed for Tycho alone, and it's become a new thing, and I thank you, George, so much for this beautiful arrangement. Also want to thank, of course, Nabila, who without... We would not be here without you, so thank you so much. We hope you enjoy Day of Remembrance. Thank you. Thank you.
I hope you're enjoying the music as much as I am. When you're in heaven and you hear some of these tunes, don't be surprised. Because this music is really heavenly. Remember, I talked to you about sustainability. So there are children that have boxes, and they're going to come among the crowd. And I'm going to tell you about sustainability. This building is a historical building, was built in 1910. It was a temple for an exclusive group. Eventually, in 1995, through grace of God, this building was gifted to us. By the way, I'm a filler while the choirs come together. I'm going to fill some of this gap. However, I want to have a message. So, through grace of God, in 1995, Islamic Cultural Center of Northern California bought this building and turned an exclusive building into an inclusive building. In this building, not only Muslims come and are welcome, people of all faith are welcomed here, and they have programs here. Over 25 organizations that don't have a place to have their activities, they come to this place and struggle towards social justice using this place, providing social services for people of all faith, not only for Muslims, but people of all faith. So this concert is free. But in order for us to be sustainable, to have the door open for all of you for many years to come here and enjoy such a wonderful music in such a beautiful place, you need to be generous. When these kids come, start dropping some money in these buckets. I know it's the old-fashioned way. Today, people go online and donate. You could do that as well. ICCNC.org. But when kids come here, donate generously. The money is going toward these free concerts, toward providing opportunities for other nonprofit organizations that work towards social justice, right? I talked about this music being heavenly. There's a teaching in Islam that God tells us that every human being was created with God's spirit in them. And I think tonight, we heard these musicians and singers and drummers expressed some of that God's spirit. That's why it was so heavenly. You didn't have to understand the language. You could tell the words are coming from up there through their heart to us. So I think I'm almost there, but if you haven't donated, raise their hands so these kids with the boxes. So you need to go quickly and put money in these boxes. And seriously, we will put it toward good use. Turn this place. This place needs some new paint. So next year you come here, it will be more shiny and more beautiful. And so you'll enjoy it even more. Thank you so much. And I think I'll have another opportunity to come here and speak few words to you as well. So again, if you came in late, as you go out, if you need to take biological breaks, because there's no intermission here, but you could walk outside. If you're a man, go to your left. If you're a lady, hang to your right, and you will find restrooms. And again, thank you all for bringing such beautiful, positive energy to our space and depositing it here. And it will help us to have better programs for everyone. Thank you so much.
Next piece, I would like to welcome La Peña and Vukani Mawetu to the stage. want to welcome now singer Sophia Buzit and director. Director George Kuri. And pianist Mary Fleming.
Living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we're gonna walk it out and move mountains. We're gonna walk it out and move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up and I'll do it 1,000 times again. And I'll rise up high like the waves. I'll rise up in spite of the air. Silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet and move mountains, bring it to its feet. And I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up and I'll do it 1,000 times again. And we'll rise up high like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up. the day will rise up. We'll rise unafraid, we'll rise up. And we'll do it a thousand times again. We'll rise up, high like the waves. We'll rise up, in spite of the ache. We'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again.
As they say in Arabic, mashallah. When I was 15 years old, I didn't have the courage to stand up in the crowd, let alone stand up here among you and sing so beautifully. I am doing my role as a filler, so pay attention to me. The musicians are going to leave the stage. Don't pay attention to them. Just look at me. What I want you to do right now, put your hands together for all the volunteers tonight. Who have done a fabulous job organizing, directing traffic, and all the hard work. Also, I want every one of you in this room pray through grace of God that our beloved director of Aswad, Nabila, be healthy for many, many years. The movie Wonder Woman is not real, but Nabila is a real Wonder Woman. Some of you were upset because you didn't have an opportunity to put money in those donation boxes. I have good news for you. Those boxes are going to be outside as you leave. You have a better chance to dig in the bottom of the pocket. Those $100 bills get stuck down there. You can pull them out and put them in the boxes. Since you've been so generous, they tell us in the cafe they prepared a lot more food than people consumed. So on the way out, maybe buy some sandwiches. On the way home, you could eat them. Or tomorrow morning, Sunday morning breakfast, old sandwiches don't taste bad, really. I want to introduce another superstar. You know, there was a superstar who sang here, and I don't know how Nabila discovered her. There's another superstar, a junior Aswad Ensemble musician, who last year we had a concert here for the seven countries that were banned from traveling here. The seven nations came here, and they had a concert. And mayor of Oakland was sitting here. And for some reason, I left out for 5 minutes to take care of something. I came back. I saw everyone had tears down their face. I didn't know what happened. So I was asking, what happened? How come everyone is crying? They told me this young musician came on the stage and recited a poem that just tore everyone's heart apart, and everyone was just bawling and crying. So, a man, Hassan, is that young musician who's going to come up on the stage and recite her poem again. Thank you.
Hi, assalamu alaikum. I'm Iman. I am a proud Somali American Muslim, and I am. Thank you. I am honored to share with you the words of a Somali poet named Warsan Shire, who, if you haven't heard of, you definitely should check out after this. This is a poem she wrote called Home, and I am ecstatic to share it with you. Home by Warsan Shire. No one leaves home unless home is the mouth of a shark. You only run for the border when you see the whole city running as well. Your neighbors running faster than you, breath bloody in their throats, and the boy you went to school with, who kissed you dizzy behind the old tin factory, is carrying a gun bigger than his body. You only leave home when home won't let you stay. No one leaves home unless home chases you, fire underfoot, hot blood in your belly. It's not something you ever thought of doing until the blade burnt threats into your neck. And even then, you carried the anthem under your breath, only tearing up your passport in an airport toilet, sobbing as each mouthful of paper made it clear that you wouldn't be going back. You have to understand that no one puts their children in a boat unless the water is safer than the land. No one burns their palms under trains beneath carriages. No one spends days and nights in the belly of a truck feeding on newspaper unless the miles traveled mean something more than journey. No one wants to be beaten or pitied. No one chooses refugee camps or strip searches where your body is left aching, or prison, because prison is safer than a city of fire, and one prison guard in the night is better than a truckload of men who look like your father. No one could take it. No one could stomach it. No one's skin would be tough enough. All the go-home blacks, dirty immigrants, refugees, asylum seekers, sucking our country dry, niggers with their hands out, they smell strange, savages, messed up their country, now they want to mess up ours. How do the words, the dirty looks roll off your back? Maybe because the blow is softer than a limb torn off, or the words are more tender than 14 men between your legs, or the insults are easier to swallow than rubble, than bone, than your child's body in pieces. I want to go home. But home is the mouth of a shark. Home is the barrel of a gun, and no one would leave home unless home told you to quicken your legs. Leave your clothes behind, crawl through the desert, wade through the ocean, drown. Save, be hungry, beg, forget pride, your survival is more important. No one leaves home until home is a sweaty voice in your ear saying, leave. Run away from me now. I don't know what I've become, but I know that anywhere is safer than here. Thank you.
And that was Iman Hassan. And up next, I want to introduce our final section of songs. It will be Spanish songs, civil rights songs, and it'll, the program will be ending with Choral Majority, which is, we want to invite you all to also sing along with us, where we will be singing No Ban, No Wall.
Good evening. My name is Lichi Fuentes. I'm one of the directors of La Peña Community Chorus. Thank you. Well, now is the time that we all join in singing, because voices singing makes a strong protest against inequality and injustice. In Chile in 1973, where I come from, there was a coup. And to appease our souls, we used to sing this song in the universities, in the place, in very few places that we could sing. But by singing together, we built a strong opposition to the dictatorship, and it made us feel safer. By not feeling alone, you create this force that can make changes. So the song that we're going to sing is called Tu Cantar, Your Singing. And Tu Cantar says, Tu cantar el viento llevará, your singing the wind will take. Alguna vez podremos todos escuchar. And it's a singing that someday everybody will be able to hear, and hear this song and sing together. So repeat after me. I used to be a teacher. Tu cantar, el viento llevará, alguna vez, podremos todos escuchar. Vamos a practicar. We're going to practice.
Podremos todos escuchar a tu cantar.
we've heard a lot about a wall, right? There is a poet from Cuba that wrote a song that is called La Muralla, which means the wall. But this muralla is not a muralla that separates people. So this is a muralla or a wall that opens the wall to bring friendship and love and caring, and closes the wall to evil and bad feelings. So we're gonna close the walls to you know who, and and open the wall, abre la muralla, for all of us to be together and live in peace. La muralla, from Cuba.
Oh,
Our last song is a song that is called "It's Gonna Take Us All." And it's gonna take for all of us to make a real change if we want to. This song was written by a very important person in the Bay Area. He passed away a few years, and he left us an incredible legacy. His name was John Frommer. It's gonna take us all.
Next portion of the program will be headed by Vukani Mwetu. Vukani Mwetu means in Zulu, people arise, and it's appropriate for now. And it was formed 32 years ago during the anti-apartheid movement in this country and in South Africa. But I want to remember and take off on the Taiko Day of Remembrance, because one of our founding members, Ricky Furukawa, died on January 3rd. He was Japanese American. His parents were among those who were rounded up and put in the camps. But he joined in the fight against apartheid and many other struggles in this country. He was a loving, compassionate member of the choir, and member of the human race. We're going to sing Sen Zeni Na, which is also appropriate for our comrade Ricky. This is a song which was sung during the funerals in South Africa for fallen comrades who had been killed by the racist South African government. It says, "What is my crime? My only crime is that I'm black." It is also appropriate that we sing this song during these days in this country, because, as you know, Black Lives Matter. The struggle continues. We must join hands to fight together, to get the whole world into a safer, more respectful place of human beings.
Amandla.
Mwetu.
Amandla.
Mwetu.
Indigenous people and those who were brought here against their will, and immigrants who helped to build our country. We are a nation with many different immigrant cultures that have enriched us and given us strength in science, technology, art, music, and agriculture. We must look for ways to work and bind us together to defeat the forces trying to pull us apart. We, the people, believe in the rights of all peoples. No Muslim immigrant ban in my name. No wall in my name. No deportations in my name.
We won't turn around. We'll flood the streets with justice. We are free to bound.
We have gone too far. We won't turn around. We'll flood the streets with justice. We are free to bound.
Oh, we have come too far.
Give it up. Give it up now. Thank you. Thank you.
We're now having members of Choral Majority and a cappella join this magnificent chorus, and you as well, to sing our final song, No Wall, No Ban. No wall, no ban on this stolen land. No ban, no wall. We will welcome all. This is a beautiful song by Ellie Grace of Kansas City.
for joining us tonight. We've been, as you can see, we've been working really, really hard. And the beautiful thing is we got the three choirs to work together on a just amazing program. And weaving all our music and our lyrics and so on. And what do you think? Did we do a good job? So, thanks a lot. We have a lot of food left over in the staff, in the performers' room, and we're really willing to share it with you because I don't know what to do with it. So you're all welcome to go take cakes, take this, take that, whatever is left. There's a lot because people were so generous. And please keep supporting ICNC. This is our home. Our home meaning Aswat Ensemble, the group that played at the beginning. This is our home. It's been our home for 7 years. So we practice here every Sunday. So you're welcome to join us. We start our next season February 4th, and we will be doing full Arabic music concert. And it could be music from the Arab world from the 80s up until present, which is totally different than this. So, and next season, we're gonna be doing Sufi music. So, I don't know where and so on, but what I suggest is you join Aswat Ensemble Facebook. And I think if you picked up a copy of the program, you'll have all the information. And then we have lots of concerts, lots of events all the time, not just the big concert like this, because we do the bank concerts, we do other concerts. So you can follow us and see where we performing. But what was really amazing to me that this is the first time that we collaborate with two other choirs. And I think